Dark, dreary, morbid, morose, and terrifying. It's the happiest day of the year. It's Halloween, Portland style. And we'll talk about it today on Outlook Portland, right here on Portland CW. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome to Outlook Portland on Portland CW. While the rest of humanity aligns their celebratory calendar around Christmas, New Year's, Kwanzaa, Boxing Day, National Clown Day, which is August 6th, there's a group of people, myself included, who plan all year for one glorious, magical, dark, and twisted night, and that is Halloween. So today we're going to find out how Portland marks this one night out of 365, starting with eight syllables. Rocky Horror Picture Show. Joining me is Lawrence Johnson, who is Secretary Historian and Master of Ceremonies for the Clinton Street Cabaret, and they perform along with, as part of, accompanying the Rocky Horror Picture Show this Halloween, which is of course Friday, October 31st. So, all right, let's talk concept for a second. So you've got the Rocky Horror Picture Show, which comes out in 1975. Sort of underperforms at the box office, and now in 2008, midnight screenings cult across classic. The country, a cult classic, a way of life. How did it go from A to Z?
Well, when it first came out, it was pretty risque for the time, and a lot of people just didn't get it, but there was a very special crowd of people that did get it, and they became huge fans, so they wanted to see it whenever they could, and so they started showing it at midnight at a lot of theaters as the midnight movie because it was fairly adult-themed. And these people would show up over and over again. Eventually, they memorized all the lines and started shouting things at the screen and throwing props at each other.
Fantastic. So it's a real grassroots phenomenon. It wasn't a construct. It wasn't some viral marketing scheme by a studio. It was a thing that fans just started doing.
Yeah, completely driven to be become a part of the movie themselves.
So for people who've never been there, for people who've never seen it live, what is the experience like, if you can summarize it?
Well, it's a very very personal experience. You really participate. For people who've never seen the movie live in our theater, we usually make them come on stage. We call them the Rocky Horror Virgins. And being the master of ceremonies, I take them on stage and we participate in some really funny and silly games. I have them do little performances or compete with each other, and that's kind of how they get initiated into the cast themselves. And you're shouting lines at each other and listening to all the funny things people are saying during the movie, trying to dodge rice and toast. So you're definitely participating.
So when people, I should say, by the way, that when I was about 7, maybe 8 years of age, my sister took me, and I don't even think she told my mom where we were going. I think she actually just said, we're going to go to the movies. And I think my mom had visions of me going off to see like 101 Dalmatians or something. And I just remember that it was this wonderful, brilliant, fantastic, but I think ultimately traumatizing and scarring experience, like in the best possible way.
Yeah.
So a cabaret implies that you're up there kind of channeling Madeline Kahn or Liza Minnelli. In this sense, what does cabaret mean with the Rocky Horror Picture Show?
Well, there's different performing groups that do this all over the country, and we all have our own special little names, but, you know, we get on stage and we dance around, and we're not necessarily singing, but we're pretty cabaret-esque in that most of us are wearing fishnets and high heels, guys and girls included.
So, why is this? It seems like this is big in Portland, especially. I mean, somebody told me, and I don't know if this is true, somebody told me that this, either the cabaret or the movie itself, that it's the longest running showing in the country.
Well, our cast has been around for 22 years, so it's definitely one of the longest running casts that stayed the same cast from beginning to end. And our theater's been showing it for one of the longest times as well. So it's definitely one of the pinpoints on the map for the biggest Rocky Horror towns.
Is there sort of a dispute over the crown? Do people, the different cities fight about it? Like, we've been here since '05 with
well,
the showing.
It's hard to say for sure how many people have been doing it for how long, but we're definitely up there, probably top three.
So why does it resonate so strongly in Portland? What is the special connection, in your opinion, between Rocky Horror Picture Show and Portland?
Well, the movie itself just kind of epitomizes giving yourself into absolute pleasure, as Tim Curry says. And Portland's just a very open-minded town. So there's a lot of kind of outcasts of society that all come together. And, you know, the night owls. And this is a place for them to gather and feel welcome. It's like a family. So all the people who aren't afraid of getting skimpy at, you know, -10 degree weather and come and see people do very explicit things. It's fun every single week for them.
Speaking of skimpy and coming to see inexplicit things, so have your mom and dad come to see this?
Actually, it's funny. Just last month, my father and his wife came, and they'd never seen it before. And I told them for years what I'd been doing, but they didn't really understand. My dad never even saw the movie before. Right. And I brought them on stage, and I de-virginized them, if you will. So that was an experience for me.
I'm picturing your dad as sort of this big Archie Bunker guy, you know, with like his sleeves rolled up and a pack of cigarettes going, son, I'm very proud of you, I suppose, in some horrible way.
You're not too far off.
Is there some poor sap that has to come and clean up the theater afterward? And if so, do you feel bad about what you do?
Well, a lot of the theater workers, they come with a leaf blower and they literally blow all the props that have been thrown onto the floor. We're trying to do meetings at the time, so we're usually shouting over the sounds of leaf blowers and brooms, but that's more their thing.
What do you think of this? I read this story, I don't know, a couple weeks back. What do you think of the news of MTV Pictures remaking Rocky Horror Picture Show?
Well, over the past years, the rumor of someone remaking the movie has come and gone many times, so I've always been a little skeptical of that, but this one seems fairly legitimate from what I've looked into. And anytime you try to remake a cult classic, they're basically, I feel, trying to take advantage of the fact that it's very popular, despite the fact that it's not a big money scheme.
Any press is good press, my friend.
It's true.
So, dumb question, what makes the Halloween screening of this or the Halloween performance so spectacular?
Well, Halloween is that one special holiday where you kind of let your inner demons out. So going to see the Rocky Horror Picture Show and experiencing this risky business is kind of fun on that holiday.
Does it give people license, do you think, to be even more over the top than they normally would?
For sure, especially when you come in costume, because we're having, you know, we do costume contests on the night of Halloween. Mm-hmm. And everyone says, if you live in Portland, you gotta come to the Rocky Horror Picture Show at least once. Most people do that once or twice a year, and Halloween's usually that night.
How many people show up for this?
Many times we do standing room only, so it's good to come early in, so we can have 200, 220 people.
Coming up next, they lurch, they stagger, and they're coming to get you, Portland. They're zombies. When Outlook Portland returns right here on Portland CW.